Welcome back to my channel. So today I would like to talk about the ENSA's protest. So you know, no matter what we do, ENSA's can never end police brutality if the right things are not in place. So please listen to what this man has to say before I continue. He's a police officer, according to him. Please listen to what he has to say.
Okay, thank you very much. Go ahead.
And that is why I'm calling.
Okay, thank you.
I joined the job 17 years ago. Though on merit, okay?
Yeah.
But I have mates at that time who spent 100,000, 150 before they could get the job. Now, the point is this. If we like, let's take away all the policemen we have today and go to media houses, get the best guy of the media. Let's go to the banks, get the best bankers. Go to church, get the best pastors. Put them there. The same thing. What is happening now will continue to happen.
Now, are you surprised about what he said? He said, even if you bring all the people from the media houses, their pastors and the likes, if you bring them into this Nigerian police force, what is happening currently will never cease to happen. Why? Do you know, as human, we all have a psychological point. We are, when you are dealing with human, you have to read what you are, you should read sentiment to it at times. Because you have to put them in your shoe. Now, let's imagine these people. He said some people even got the job by paying up to 150,000. Imagine someone that paid 150,000 naira to get a job. The first thing he's going to do is to find the money. It's just like our politicians. When we vote them in, before them we ask for money. After voting them, we have to pay back. That's why on so many occasions they will just do us anyhow they like, because they feel like, after all, I've paid for it. Now, if you check what this man is saying, the man has been in service for 17 years, 17 good years. He is a sergeant. Let's take it from his recruitment stage to constable, corporal, then sergeant, 17 times the ladder to climb just 30 steps. 17 years, 18 years to go. Now, let me tell you, let's say it. If he's going to continue this way, it means he's not going to reach maybe DS before he leaves the service. Now, look at how many, what is the percentage? What is the average year, what they call it? One rank before being promoted to the other. That is average of 5 to 6 years. Is that what the constitution of this country says? Are they going to spend up to 6-7 years before they get promoted to another rank? And you expect them to give us the best of them? That is not going to happen. Now, let's put that aside. This man says he's collecting 53 or 63,000 naira. Imagine that, as sergeant in the Nigerian police force. Why those people in the SAS, they are not going to even bother themselves about promotion or anything, because they know initially they were doing their job. They were doing it even up to this present time. Before they were disbanded, they were doing their job. Although they see these yahoo guys as opportunity. Okay, if you can give me my share, you can go. After all, if with you, nothing will happen. That is the kind of situation that we are behind in this country. Had it been after arresting them, the law is going to take its course on them, then those people who arrest them, they will not feel bad. But imagine arresting the yahoo guy. Where you are standing is where he is freed. Maybe from just one call. From a call, they can just tell you, hey, leave him, let him go. Or that you did your best and take him to court. On getting to the court, they can ask you that, hey, he doesn't do anything because he has the pay, then he will go. That is why these people also are like, if I collect my share, you can go to hell, do whatever you want, I don't care. But once I know that you are having this stuff with you, I'm going to take my share and you go. We can't even deny the fact that these SAS officers, they know the Yahoo guys, they know them. So all of them are working hand in hand. They are working hand in hand. So that is why it is very, very hard for them to do their job. So if we want this country to be better, if we want these people to work, if we want Nigerian police force to work, we have to consider this promotion of a team. If can you imagine if you do go and do your go and carry out your survey of it. Go on a highway, check the percentage of people that are carrying arms. You will see them. They are old people. Old people who got into this job with maybe school certificate as recruits. They will never climb to the top of enjoying this profession. They will never. They will remain as errand till they leave the service. Why? Is it because we are having Nigerian university? Is it because people are entering the force through direct short service or tradesmen or whatever? Even if they are going to have that, we should make provision for those people that could not afford higher education. Those people that are not rich to the extent of sending their children attending Nigerian Police University or Nigerian Army University, because this thing that is happening in the police is also happening in the army. The those people that entering the force with O level, they are having a lot of challenges. Even after acquiring further education, they won't be able to include their certificate in order for them to upgrade. Now, you are telling them that it is a kind of psychological disturb when you are having someone that just joined the force 2 years ago is approaching a SP, why you that you have been in the service for 20-25 years, you are still an inspector. That won't lead us to anywhere. We just have to face the fact this country we like to dangerous stuff. There's nothing bad in us having a army university, police university. If we are going to put the best things in place, we have to reform this Nigerian police force. Otherwise, it will get to a particular time that period that we are going to have senior police officers and we are not going to have junior ones. What is happening currently that they are asking them to recruit 10,000 constables is going to happen again, because by that time Nigerian Police University is rolling out graduates every year, and once they graduate from that place, they become senior police officers. So imagine them having senior police officers 2,000 this year, 2,000 next year, 2,000 the following year, 2,000 the following year. Now, minimum of 2,000 I'm saying. Now imagine that in the same thing is happening in the Nigerian army. In the next 10 years, you will have police officers from above the rank of ASP. There will be many compared to the constable that are doing the job, because nobody will want to go for that particular job again. And by the time we lose interest in that, people lose complete interest in the policing system, then nobody will want to serve anybody. So we just have to see these people as human, address their needs, increase their pay, body calm them. Even SAS shouldn't be seen on this road. They are special anti-robbery squad. They are expected to be stationed in every state, every local government. They should be drafted in times of emergency. it should be drafted in terms of emergency. That is what the name even connotes, special anti-robbery squad. When there is robbery anywhere, send them, and they shouldn't just be going without any with vest. Hey, imagine with vest, no bulletproof, no kids, nothing. So we should make sure that we treat them like human. Let them be professional. We watch Hollywood movies. We see how the Marines, American Marines are. We see the New York police, how they are. So if possible, body cam them when they are going for operations. Let them have drones. We are in modern days. Let them have drones. If you cannot buy drone, tell our universities, our polytechnics to produce something. We will be using it like that. Why is this country like this? Can't we produce something? We doing things that we make life easier for us. FRS should stop pursuing cars. Customs should stop pursuing cars. There are many ways that we can do it. Mount secret cameras on our roads. Let everybody be documented. Before they get home, you will know who they are on citing their plate number. Why are we having dollars in security apparatus? Are we being led by stupid people that don't understand what is happening in the world? I don't believe that. If we can do the right thing, this country will move forward. I will always support Nigerian police force. Anything that has to do with security in this country, I am for it. Whether people like this, you say I have people there, that's my own problem, that's their own problem. But I know I'm not going to lay this country down. I will continue to do my best. I've enrolled to be a Nigerian police officer before. I've done it. I was as ASP. And as time goes on, I couldn't proceed. I was disqualified. It doesn't hurt anything. That doesn't make me to hit them. It doesn't worth it. I've been extorted by police officers. So what else? The only thing is that I've never been harassed by SAS because I'm not going to appear like whom they want. That is it. People that they want. I call them their customers because they know each other. On sighting SAS, they will be jittering. SAS are coming. So we should be very serious in this country. If we are serious, everything will work out for us for good. So please subscribe to my channel. If you have any correction or anything to say, please feel free to add it. Thank you very much.
If you want to hear the truth about policing in this country, go to rank and file, the corporal, the sergeant, and the constable, and the inspector. They will tell you the truth.